Now here we are to have a look at how to do a recording via one of these 8-track studios. And the one I'm using today is a Tascam DP-03, a small beast. There it is. Can you see that properly? Basically you have two channels. I'm using one with a Canon connector for the microphone. One for a keyboard that I'll be using later on after the initial guitar and vocal goes down. Each of these has its own volume control and we select our switch, mic, line, or is it for guitar only? Slightly different sensitivities. Two lines of rotary knobs, and the top one is reverb, the bottom one is your pan. Quite handy to actually have physical knobs there, I do feel. And then you have your sliders down the bottom for each individual channel. Over this side, transport controls, stop, play, record, and various other little buttons that do various other little things. Now, this song that I'm going to do is just quite a simple piece, very brief. It's got three verses, but I'm only going to do the first verse just to give you an idea how things proceed. You'll notice I'm using headphones because I want to be able to hear what's coming through, that I'm not too loud, that I'm not too close to the microphone. If I get too close to the mic, we'll get that popping when you're singing a B or a P sound. There'll be this minor explosion through the mic if you're too close. The mic I'm using is one of these Rodent, it's a Legend it's called. It's pretty sensitive, but you don't want a mic that's too sensitive. It'll depend on your own environment what mic you actually choose. If, for instance, I have a lot of traffic noise outside, then I might want to go back to, you know, something like this, the old Shure mics, which are fine, but this one's an all-round one. This is the ball head one. If I had a really noisy environment, I would want the straight one, not the SM58 type. This one is this is the 565. This is basically the posh SM58. I had one of these, which I bought when I was 17, and it gave up the ghost 40 years later. 40 years I got out of it, so this is a new one I got. I thought, well, the first one did me alright, I'll just get another one. That's what I use when I'm actually gigging, when I'm out live. It can be used through this, but you've got to be quite close to it, therefore you have to be aware of the popping issue. If you have a mic that's too sensitive, as I say, you'll pick up all the extra noises that are going on in a house, the radiators clicking and the plumbing going and a cow breaking wind three fields away, that sort of thing, you know, whatever your situation happens to incorporate. Right, so let's see now, what do I do first of all with the Tascam? I have to create a song, a space for it to go into. So I hit menu and a little list comes up. And the first one says song, so that sounds pretty good. There's a little arrow saying proceed, and there's a button that says exit. So let's hit the arrow that says proceed. And we have load, save, and create. Well, we want to create, so again, hit the little arrow and ask me for the name of the song. This particular one is called Maranatha. I know I could have picked something with a simpler title. That just means Jesus come or Lord come. So I twiddle this around until I get to a letter. Yes, the letter M. You guessed it, didn't you? And then I press the wee button that's down here. It shoves me on to the next letter. And we go to A. Right, I've got Margot. That'll do, that's close enough. Hit execute, and it creates the song for me, which takes just a second. And then we go back to home, and what I'm looking at is, I'll show you, there's the little display there. And that's what I'm seeing just now. That'll show me how loud I'm going. When I sing, I don't want to hit the top of the, or the roof of the diagram, because that would create a distortion. I want to be able to see the column, the moving column that goes up and down as the volume varies. I want to see it actually moving. I don't want it just to be kind of, I want a fair bit of movement in it, but I don't want it hitting the top because that will cause a distortion. Now, at the moment I'm wearing headphones, but I can't actually hear anything through them. I have to arm the track. This is common to most 8-tracks that you'll come across. The wee button, and oh right, I've pressed that, a little red light is flashing and I can now hear things through the headphones. Now you might notice one arm is clothed, my other arm, oh, it's naked, whoa, on YouTube, a naked arm on YouTube. Why would I do that? Well, I'm wearing a shirt, and shirts have on the cuff buttons. And when you're strumming, what does the button do? Yes, it clicks off the front of the acoustic guitar, doesn't it? So we don't want that. So this is it's slightly uncomfortable in the winter, but it's not too bad now. We're into spring, so it's not too bad just now. Now I've set the sensitivity on this track. I've got guitar, mic, oblique line, and an internal mic. I'm not using the internal mics, they're okay on any of these machines, just as a memory thing. What was that tune I came up with at 11:30 last night? They're good for that, but they're just not good enough to do a demo to send to anyone or to post on the net, in my opinion. They also have the disadvantage that when you start them, there's one almighty bang on the machine because you've just pressed one bit of plastic against another right on top of the mic. Yeah, and the same again when you finish the piece, when you stop it, a great almighty bang, which you're going to have to get rid of somehow. So we're not using that, using the good, decent mics that are not going to break the bank, and as I say, they're not going to pick up the noise of Radio 1 on Mars or whatever. Right, here we go. We're in the KFC, and I have checked before I even started that my guitar was in tune and at concert pitch, because it's going to have to blend with the keyboard. I don't want to have to start messing about changing the pitch on the keyboard. Now I'm going to do a counting, and rather than count 1, 2, 3, 4, I'm going to leave the 4 silent. I won't start playing until the first beat of the next bar, but I don't want the word 4 bleeding into the introduction itself, so it will be silent. Now, at this point, this is where you usually burst into the song, you think, you're doing great, it's wonderful, but what have you forgotten to do? Ah, you've forgotten to press the record button, haven't you? So we'll do that first of all. Press record and play. One, two, three.
Come lift your voice and sing to one that we know is king, and humble hearted sing, Jesus is Lord. Maranatha, Jesus come. Maranatha, Jesus come.
Now, did you notice at the end of the song there, I did absolutely nothing. I didn't breathe. I didn't swallow. I didn't move. I was like a statue. And that's because I don't want any noises coming. If I move, oh, what can you hear? Oh, look, I can actually hear the guitar moving against the fabric of my jeans. All right. Some guitars are worse. This one's all right. It's not too bad. I've had ones that... Yes, I have actually sat here on occasion with no trousers on playing a guitar because it creaked on my jeans. Obviously not something one does in mixed company. Right, so that's the first basic track, and that took a minute and a second. Obviously I wasn't singing for the whole minute, but that's as long as it is. Okay, so we run it back. And we would then listen to it and make sure it had actually recorded. Let's have a listen. One, two, three.
Come lift your voice and sing to one that we know is king, and humble hearted sing, Jesus is Lord.
That's enough. Nothing untoward happened there. Run it back. Now we're at the stage of putting on some keyboard parts, and I'm using a Yamaha MX-49 to do this. I'm only going to put on three other instruments. That'll be an acoustic bass, which I'll do in a moment, then some strings and an accordion at the end. Okay, right, so I'm using acoustic bass number 4 in the bass section here. I have activated channel number 2. I have removed the mic, and I've also making sure that I have not activated channel number 1, because that's where the original guitar and voice are. So I don't want to cover that up again. So on channel 2, if I just play a note just now, you'll see the plenty of movement on the faders there, but not hitting the roof. Okay, so it's record and play. One, two, three.
Come lift your voice and sing to one that we know is king, and humble-hearted sing, Jesus is Lord. Maranatha, Jesus, come. Maranatha, Jesus, come.
Now, while I'm here, I'm at 55 seconds, 2 seconds longer than the actual piece of music. I'm going to do a wee thing that's required called setting the out. There's a little button down here, a little orange marker under it, says set out. Now, all that does is it tells the machine this is how long the song is to be, so this is where everything stops. So I press it once, and it confirms it up on the screen. You must do that if you want to save your song. It won't let you save otherwise. Okay, so that's done. Cancel the red light. Run it back. And let's have a quick listen.
One, two, three. Come lift your voice and sing to one that we know is king, and humble-hearted sing, Jesus is Lord.
Right, that's fine. Run it back again. I will pan it slightly. I'll pan the bass over to the 10 o'clock position on the dial. Going to the left there. Now, my next sound will be going on channel 4. Let's put the fader up so I can hear what it will be. And it will be the string section. Strings, and I've chosen number 16, small ensemble. Now let's see if my octave is right. Well, because it had it dropped for the bass, so. Maybe down one. Oh, that's nice. Right, let's see what that sounds like. I'll try one up again with two hands. Yeah, I like that, that sounds nice. Okay, now let's just maybe put the volume up a wee bit, rather quiet. Once more.
One, two, three. Come lift your voice and sing to one that we know is King, and humble hearted sing, Jesus is Lord. Maranatha, Jesus come. Maranatha, Jesus come.
Very nice, that sounded okay. Again, cancel the light. We listen back.
One, two, three. Come lift your voice and sing to one that we know is King, and humble-hearted sing, Jesus is Lord.
Yeah, that'll do. I've panned that to the right, to the 2 o'clock position, and added a little reverb on it. Now, my last sound that I'm going to put on is going to be the accordion. Why accordion, you say? Well, and why not police car? Oh, yes. See, even in the countryside. Yep. My next section is going to be the accordion. And you might ask, well, why an accordion? Well, a general thing that applies to recording is, what does your voice sound like? You might have noticed I have an accent, and it's a Scottish accent. And of course the accordion is an instrument that is widely used in Scotland. It's part of our local culture. So that's why I'm going with the Scottish thing. I have in the past, many, many years ago, been rejected by a record company because I sounded too Scottish. Ah, great. That was just before the great Celtic thing all became fashionable. It was about a year before that. Ah. Oh well, such is life. So I'm going to go with that. If I had a really gruff voice, well, I would have been a heavy metal artist. But I've got a fairly gentle singing voice, so the folky thing suits me. Or another way of putting it is, I can get away with it. Right, accordion. We are in the organ section, and it's number 59 in the organ section. Where's my octave now? And I'm only going to bring this in at the chorus. One, two, three.
Come lift your voice and sing to one that we know is King, and humble hearted sing, Jesus is Lord.
I think that was a bit better. Right, let's have a listen.
One, two, three. Come lift your voice and sing to one that we know is King, and humble hearted sing, Jesus is Lord. Maranatha, Jesus, come. Maranatha, Jesus, come.
Yep, that's fine. Now, the next stage, I'm happy with my mix. I have to hit a wee button up here that says mix down mastering. So it's on mix down just now, and I record again, and that basically sets this in stone. All the once this is done, there's no point in footering about with any of these knobs, because it won't make a blind bit of difference.
One, two, three. Come lift your voice and sing to one that we know is King, and humble hearted sing, Jesus is Lord. Maranatha, Jesus, come.
That's it, and it stops automatically at the 55 seconds, because earlier on I marked the set out. Now, might find that useful, a wee diagram. Tracks 1 up to 8, and you just fill in at the angle where your reverb was, where your pan was, and what your voice is. You get channel 1, guitar and voice. 2, bass, number 4, channel 4 was. Small ensemble number 16, and in 6 it was accordion at 59. The reason that I've used 2, 4 and 6 for my instruments is purely the way the default setting on this is, that all the odd channels are devoted to input 1 and the even channels to input 2. But you can change it all on the screen if you so desire. And where was my keyboard volume during the whole thing? That I could be looking back at this, it might be 6 months before I do another recording, and thinking, well, that one's sounding nice. How did I do it? So that's it. Any questions, stick them in the comments box. Don't have to be just about the Tascam, it could be about recording in general.